MDL gods.
Not going too well. They need to go back to picking this fella, LD. And I mean the LD.
Oh.
The Lone Druid. Go back to the Misery Lone Druid. It was their, like, bread and butter in the group stages. They were doing well with it. The Lone Druid Spectre. I don't think... I mean, there's not, like, clear synergy between them. It was more the setup where they have a offlane farmer, a safe lane farmer, and then we on the tempo controller, so... It worked well for them, so...
Well, we'll see if they can find a replacement for the Earth Spirit, or if they do get it, perhaps, as he was impressive with it, the draft has begun. Game 2 is officially underway. And we'll hop into it now.
Ooh, they had first pick, and they got
They do get the Earth Spirit, so...
Here we go. Second pick, Lone Druid. We'll see it happen.
Unless Newbie take it away. Not a hero they go for.
They're not Lone Druid pickets. It's just the Western teams playing Lone Druid. I was telling Dakota, it feels like for the first time, like the... Many, many years. Like, you go back to, like, TI3, TI4 era, it was always the Western teams who were more the trendsetters and changing the metagame. It feels like kind of the other way around. Here is, like, Morphling and Terrorblade were being picked up first by the Eastern teams. Faceless Void, another good example. And the Western teams had a few of their own picks, but they don't seem to be doing as well. Like, the Lone Druid, perhaps, you could say. Well, I think Lone Druid's kind of been 50-50. OD, another hero, I think maybe you've seen more of the Western teams and...
Well, they're not trendsetters yet because the Western teams aren't copying them. If they win the tournament and then the Western teams copy them, then they'll be the trendsetters.
I think there has been some, maybe not direct copying, but like EG as well as Secret played their first games of Morphling on the new patch. They played their first games of Terrorblade on the new patch. So they played these heroes in the past, but they hadn't played it all in the new patch until like LGD and Vici were owning with these heroes. So they were definitely picking up. The Morphling especially was one where I was like, ooh. Envy's playing Morphling, or Arteezy was playing Morphling, which is something they hadn't done in the past at all. Like, I can't think of Arteezy ever really being known for having played much Morphling in the past.
Well, let's see if he pokes his head out this time. Waterman is available. Newbie gonna start things off with the Darkseer Spiritbreaker, and there's your Lone Druid for Secret. So they secure the offlane carry. We'll have to wait and see what the safe lane one is gonna be.
Yep. I actually reckon Jug's better than the Spectre as far as like the overall strategy where you're pushing high ground with the Spirit Bear with a healing ward. That was what Alliance just dominated with during Star Ladder. Like, that bear just becomes unkillable when you've got this percent-based healing backing it up. But they like the Spectre because of the synergy with the Earth Spirit. You find a pickoff with the stun into Rolling Boulder and Spectre Haunts, and it's a guaranteed kill. And Spectre goes for this Urn, Yasha, Diffusal, Manta-type fighting build, and it's Earth Spirit can just kill anyone on the map with a Spectre Haunt backing him up, so... It's two, like, different combos, whether they want the combo with the Earth Spirit Spectre or they want the push with the Lone Druid Jug. They haven't done the Jug. I think just, I mean, as far as how you win the game, you need to push buildings. You don't need to kill heroes, so.
Yeah, I did cast a game where they lost with the combo, so it is by no means an auto-win.
Yeah.
But definitely has a strong peak in the mid-game when you get your Manta Diffusal on the Spectre. As for Newbie, they're taking their time here with their first ban, trying to decide what they want to snap away from Secret. Venge gets ignored here early on. Generally is a pretty quick grab. And interesting to see Newbie go for the Spirit Breaker, even over the Night Stalker, which some of the other teams like Vici have preferred. Yeah. So they are going to force Secret to do something different.
Yep.
So they will ban out the Mercurial Spectre.
I like the Spirit Breaker. You can just like run at a Lone Druid, and like that's something you charge past his bear. You're not going to get rooted. You just bash his bear on the way through. So I think Spirit Breaker, a very good pick in general against Lone Druid. 10 seconds. And he's just nice and tanky, so...
We'll see if they can pull off the Fenrir level of aggression where they actually managed to kill Lone Druid early on.
Yeah.
This is one of the best carries to deal with him, the Razor, but does get removed from the pool. No Static Link shenanigans. Also, Sunday Newbie appear to like these fairly low farm priority mids for Moo.
So Newbie can throw another ban at Envy if they want to take out Jug or Ember Spirit, but... Wonder if they're going to start thinking about the Pilot Eye type supports, like the Roamers that can cause problems, heroes that can benefit and just gank a lot with the Earth Spirit early on. Like, the Bounty Hunter is always a possibility, although I'm not really liking Bounty Hunter into Spirit Breaker Darks here. That's probably actually a disaster case. But some of those strong supports that can also cancel off the Spirit Breaker charge. So you look at heroes like Rubick, you look at Lion, and heroes that can actually prevent the Spirit Breaker charges from being successful.
Oh, there's the Venge. So, not going to sneak through any longer. Newbie removed the Terror Blade, and there's still Envy heroes out there. We saw the Ember earlier this tournament. You mentioned he's been experimenting with the Morphling, so it's tough to fully ban him out.
So newbie in Venge is just amazing. Any game, any, and it can be a four position Venge, five can be played as a carry.
I've been less impressed by the carry Venges overall, but
absolutely. I think it works only if you have like a big snowballing mid and like an offlaner who's getting lots of farm.
But the one who's been very impressive is Burning on the carry Venge. I feel like he's had the most success overall.
And Darkseer is an offlaner who farms a lot, so if you get like a mid, like an Invoker or something, I think an Invoker Venge Darkseer makes a pretty good kind of core trio to push, be as strong in the mid game. Even your late game's not too shabby.
Witch Doctor now snapped up by Secret, so they get another hero to sustain the push. You mentioned Healing Ward. Yep. Well, a little Voodoo Restoration will do in a pinch. Could still go for the Jug if their heart's desire. Kind of tough for a Darkseer to kill him off as well.
Yeah. Jug lanes well enough against Darkseer just because of Healing Ward, and Witch Doctor zones really well. I mean, Alliance just showed how good Jug Lone Druid is at Starlight. I'm surprised the teams playing Lone Druid who came to MDL haven't been using the duo after Alliance had the success they did.
I wonder what newbie won here. They're pretty mid-game focused right now. No hard carry to speak of, and they're going to go for a Bristle. This is someone that can man up on the bear and not easy to burst down. Another tanky presence. Also a tough kill for the Earth Spirit. They've now got three tanks against Earth Spirit, so there's no real easy pickoffs here.
And they've got heroes who can build mech, pipe, Crimson Guard even if you want to block some of the bear damage. And that's something very useful against all the AoE damage coming out from the Earth Spirit with Magnetize, later on the Lone Druid with Radiance. So really liking kind of what newbie have put together here.
I am interested to see who that final piece of the puzzle is for newbie. But first, we'll have to see what Secret want to go for. Maybe going to hang off on their carry. They do go for the AA pickup now. I think they're starting to worry about this newbie group up. As you mentioned, seeing all these heroes that can build the big five-man items. And just generally deathball.
Yeah, maybe able to. I mean, there's no heal on these heroes straight up, but the mech type items that they're going to pick up means you can at least jump one and focus them down. But Secret don't actually have any like initiation outside the Earth Spirit, and it's very much kind of like AoE damage right now. So I'm wondering if their last pick for MB will be something like, Wraith King got banned out, where you can blink on, choose a target, and try to burst them down with the follow-up Ice Blast. So. And that's a main issue the Jug pick brings to the table, is it doesn't give you any kind of reliable control or something that can give you another good initiating tool.
Maybe Ember, but Ember is not great against Crimson Guard, and Bristle very often does build it.
Sven, perhaps, is the alternative to the Wraith King.
They have a lot of ways to control and kite a Sven.
Nice thing for Seeker is they have the final pick, so they can see what newbie are going to be running mid, and that's going to kind of decide a lot of newbie's overall strategy, because they can push pretty well. Like, they want to fight for sure. They've got really good team fight, but whether or not they're going to be playing more towards the late game or trying to push end things fast is somewhat reliant on what mid they're picking up for Moo.
Secret taking their time with the last ban here. Trying to think what newbie want to round this draft out. And also, how are they looking to lane it here? Are they running to like a Darkseer or Bristle mid versus our Spirit?
No.
Are we going to see them both as the side laners and something else for the mid lane?
They could do Bristle mid as a solo. It's not too bad.
They ban out the Lycan. Yeah. Secret. They don't want to get pushed down.
What's a newbie
hero?
They want
this to go late.
They like TA. They also, in the past, ran quite a lot of Dragon Knight for Moo. But I think TA is like one of Moo's best heroes. And
is he good this game, though? They're going to have a lot of damage over time.
Yeah, the Refraction gets burned away pretty.
And there's like no defensive supports. But I guess they're dire. They're likely to be able to get Roche.
Yeah.
I think they're a little too physical damage maybe at that point.
Lena actually seems really good. They get some single target
burst
damage.
I like Lena better there.
Be able to force some of these heroes up.
What's it going to be, newbie? We can't see their bonus time because of the overlay. So I was going to say, man, newbie, you're really coming down to the wire here. All right, 35 seconds. They got some time. I speak for the trees. Ooh.
So Bristle mid, I guess.
This is what EG did with the Prophet versus Lone Druid.
It's actually really annoying to lane against, because when you're a safe lane Prophet, you just right-click the Lone Druid hero with your treants while you last hit with your hero. And
as soon as you get phase boots, Lone Druid actually gets bullied really hard.
You're
and
such
if you have a support
Lone
there
Druid
to help,
against that.
If you have a support there to help, he gets the phase boots way ahead of your level progression.
And if you ever try and, like, contest and trade hits, suddenly a Spirit Breaker comes charging in and bam, you're dead. So you can't even try and play aggressive and go toe-to-toe with the Prophet because of that charge threat.
All right, Secret. They have 15 seconds here to go. And they are going to go for the Envy Ember, as mentioned. So a pretty standard Envy hero. Can cancel the charge. They don't really have much catch for him.
Yeah, it's the comfort aspect of the hero. Can cancel charge, can lane all right against Darkseer, can catch any split-pushing Prophet later on in the game.
But it does make for a pretty greedy conclusion to the draft now. A lot of space required for both of their carries. It's probably going to be that 3 protect 2 once again.
And that was when they did the Spectre with the Lone Druid, that Envy could actually create space for Misery. And that's something which is, like, you look at how Alliance and how they had success with the Lone Druid is they always had their mid and their carry creating space for the Lone Druid. I don't feel like Ember does that as well. He generally wants to play a bit greedy and secure his own farm. And Envy's playstyle on Ember is even more towards, like, the greedy side, the farming side, rather than the, like, Matumba Man Ember Spirit, which fights a ton and always looks to get involved in kills. Like, the way he would play, like, around the mind control docks, he was always like, fight, 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 let's... I don't even need my Boots of Travel, I just want to come TP in, initiate, and that's something which a playstyle that Envy doesn't do as much.
Where's Storm, by the way?
He's dead. He's no longer one of the spirits.
I would love to see the three spirit draft. You know?
You could fit it
get
in.
The Ember, I mean, they need to add a fourth spirit to the game. What would be the next one?
Wind
Do
spirit?
You go like the Captain Planet direction and add heart to the
heart?
Game? The power of love. Who would be the heart spirit?
No one wants to pick that. No one wants. That's the reject spirit, you know.
Put that one in the trash.
All right, Sentry got him. Uses a Tengo.
Oh, that's big.
Perhaps not need it, but you want to make sure you get the last hit, doesn't get denied, and you're scared of getting ganked. That's also just big because Darkseer gets a ton of XP from that, which means this offlane gets a lot easier for him because he gets level 2 that much quicker. So he's not worried about as much about getting killed at level 1 by the Witch Doctor AA. So having an early D ward
could be a game changer.
Handy. Yep.
And the rune is going to spawn. Newbie, maybe think about contesting this, though. They've got four in position. The cask is going to bounce nicely, though. They get Moo in front. He's not all that tanky at this stage of the game. He has gone for the quills, and he's forced to pop the Fairy Fire. Just a drive-by feed from the Bristle and a double Bounty Rune grab for Secret. Off to the races, looking for how does have to teleport out, and will actually barely make it. Yeah. Cask was cooling down there.
Okay. Lanes are looking good now. You don't
Secret are in fantastic shape.
Yep. Double Bounty Rune, first blood. And a low HP Nature's Prophet for Misery to lane against, which makes this lane a lot easier for him. And Ember and Darkseer fought over the bottom rune, and it went the way of the Ember, too, so. That was, like,
the dream start.
Yeah, dream scenario. Bristle really just overestimating how tanky he was going to be there when he ran in trying to quill spray people down. And, like, newbie level 1 fight, just it's okay. It's not great. Like, Spirit Breaker is always, like, a kind of level 2 specialist when he has charge as well as bash. He can't bash heroes on the way through the charge until the level 2, so.
Well, rough beginning. Let's see if they can salvage this one. For now, it is going to be the offlane Lone Druid. Just 1v1 against the Nature's Prophet. Supports are roaming all over the place currently. Yeah. Maybe trying to set up on Weeha. They do have the charge available.
Go for the Curious Knight. That'll get you back in the game, maybe.
May want Weeha.
Yeah,
trying to keep the creeps away from his tower. Chuan is sticking around
he
for
didn't
quite
get
a while.
If he'd gotten a kill, they might be expecting a really early bottle to come out, but his bottle's still very fast.
So Venge instead will roam on the top lane, perhaps, but Lone Druid full HP, so this should be okay.
And gets down that nice lane ward so you can keep tabs of when Lone Druid's falling back to that big camp, as well as when he's at his tower.
And with Spirit Breaker and Prophet, they can definitely gank him there.
And this is an amazing ward to have when you have Spirit Breaker and against a hero that wants to farm that jungle camp. So, good spot to be in. 2 minute rune coming up, and it looks like a bit of a fight over the bottom one, perhaps.
Little rumble in the river. Could be brewing. Leh, able to back himself away, has the charge ready to go, but they would be charging into the cask from Pylaidai, who actually just got thrown out. So maybe they can come out of this. They're going to lose Leh from the looks of things. Has the Fairy Fire, keeps him alive a little bit longer, but Pi will be the trade. So it's going to end up being a 2-for-1, most likely. The kick roll combination comes through. Weeha, uh-oh. Maybe he's in trouble now. Double Ion Shell could go his direction. He's going to be forced to turn and run. There's the surge onto Hao on the Nature's Prophet, getting right in the thick of things. This leaves the Ven just the farmer in the top lane. Very unexpected way for the lanes to reconfigure. And already there's a charge back towards top.
Just Misery better not feel too safe up here just because Prophet TP'd out. This charge with a double damage Venge is actually a little bit on the threatening side. Venge level 1, though, so no Hao.
The damage is a bit lacking, but if nothing else.
Oh, that's actually cancels the charge with the Roar, the Savage Roar.
Oh, no, he doesn't have... I think it actually hit there first, didn't it?
No.
He doesn't have Bash yet.
He used it from the bear on the charge through, it looked like.
Oh, I thought he was... Oh, yeah, you're right, because he was charging the hero, not the bear.
Yeah, that was a cool play.
It looked like he had charged and just hit the bear and then stopped, but...
Yeah, so maybe actually, I just kind of assumed like, oh, Lone Druid going to be very vulnerable to those charge kicks, but if you position the bear right and...
What's the AoE on it? It's pretty low, right?
Not sure.
325.
It's long enough.
It's like chains, I guess. It's pretty doable.
Yeah, you can do it before he hits you, but...
They're thinking about a jump of Misery, another charge. Where's the backup?
He's got Savage Roar.
Needs help. Too late.
Only got the two heroes. He tried to position his bear to catch all three, but newbie positioned so that he couldn't get all three of them.
Very timely bash there as well. Might have lived without it. Or at least forced the Spearbreaker to trade away his own life. So, in good news for newbie as well. Uh-oh, that's not good news. Tule going to try to salve up through this Maledict. Looks like it should be enough to keep him alive. But Bristleback has caught up very nicely.
Yeah. And Darkseer having a good time in the offlane's got 11 CS, close to level 4. Envy's not really free farm. He's close to free farm. He's probably getting like 80 to 90%, but... The Iron Shell will mess with you a bit, force you to use a bit more HP regen, maybe even cause you to miss a last hit here or there.
Now the phase boots come out and the fun begins for Nature's Prophet. Closing in on the level 6, slowly but surely. And once he gets that with the Spearbreaker, Darkseer, you gotta imagine newbie are gonna be face rushing the crap out of Secret. But for now, I am curious to see how much Weehaw can get down. He was very impressive yesterday on... And in fact, so far the entire tournament on the Earth Spirit, and he'll need to be.
That first level 6 magnetize is kind of when he normally comes into the picture.
Yeah, I wonder who his target will be this game.
Prophet, a good Prophet or Dex is fine. Any of the core heroes, really. I think more than anything, you just want to use it, get a kill, and try then just get the cooldown rolling. And it's more about the space creation for the rest of your team. By just forcing rotations out of newbie. And even if you don't get a kill with it, you force like 3 or 4 heroes your way. It's space for Lone Druid to farm, for Ember to farm.
Smoke from Secret.
They're prepping, I guess, with Wii getting close to that level 6. I'm going to be able to back him up. Possibly get a kill here on the mid lane, since there's no cores in the top lane.
They might want Hao, or are they wrapping around on mid?
Those two can't really kill Hao unless there's a TP up there, which Wii can definitely do. He's an Earth Spirit, so...
I guess they're going to go for the more local kill. Yeah. Sweeping around in the mid lane. There they go with the boulder kick, but it misses. The smoke gets revealed. Pi did poke his head out. And the timing is now lost. Yeah. So looks like they're not going to find the opening there. Good effort by Secret, but it is not rewarded.
Yeah, right idea, just slightly off on the execution.
Meanwhile, newbie also on the roam here off in the dire jungle. Are they looking for a jump perhaps on the bottom lane? Ember is level 6 now, though, so that's a tough kill. We'll see how summons some Treants. He does have the Nature's Wrath, and newbie really want to play around that. They might be setting up on Envy. They're trying to get in position. It looks like just finagling around through the trees. No Radiant Vision, but again, with the Remnants, this will be tough. They're going to try 40s pop the Flame Guard, though, right as they charge in. And he's not able to get the chains off. Didn't quite have the mana for it. Actually, the stick charges. Envy just chain stunned for days and nights as the Prophet ult completes the kill. But now they're in pretty far. Maledict was deployed, and it is dropping newbie low here. There's the magnetized rotation. Killing off one, looking for Tule. He's going to roll the wrong direction, though, and ticks down anyway to the Maledict. So they get the counter kills. It's an Ember in exchange for a Darkseer and a Spearbreaker. So 2-for-1.
Yeah. I think slightly better
for newbie. The instant smoke. All right, they're going back in. They want a piece of the puppy. Can they get him? Cask is going to bounce beautifully. Newbie grouping up a bit too much, and perhaps Wii looks for a little more now if they stick around too much longer. But these heroes are pretty tanky. No magnetize, so they'll make it up.
That still feels okay for newbie, killing off the Envy, Ember Spirit, and Secret committing and rotating everyone except the Lone Druid down in the bottom lane. Although Newbie kind of followed up themselves with a rotation.
This LD is having a great game, though.
Yeah.
34 CS on Misery. See Led charge over to the top lane. Gets the incidental bash off on the... Or Spirit, in the meanwhile.
And Misery immediately pings the ward, saying, how's he charging me from mid lane? Well, at least the ward has to be here.
Unfortunately for Misery, it's about to expire. Mm. But so, showing some good game sense. So... Misery, he pretty much always gets the Iron Talon in the offlane, right? No? I guess he hasn't gotten it yet. He's just, I guess he's... it seems like players are very, you know, different in their views on that. Some always rush it. Yeah. Some get it a little later on. Some will get it if they're not having a great time in the lane.
And I've seen some players who will get it one game and then not get it the next. And just, it's just whether they decide to get it or not get it in the moment.
It seems like it comes down, like, if you have free farm or close to it, then maybe you just rush the Midas, seems to be a lot of the thinking.
They'll even often have the Ring of Protection and then just never use it to make
anything. Never complete it. Well, maybe save it for the Vlads later on, but... Yeah, it's definitely a flexible aspect of the hero now.
So, Drums Prophet, but definitely following this will be, I feel like, essential to get an Orchid against Ember when you've got no other good, reliable control to deal with him.
No, they're going to converge here on Puppy. Quills are stacking up. They want a good Cask to come through and maybe turn this one around. The Maledix there. Cask. Newbie taking a lot of damage under the tower. Then the Magnetize from Weeha arrives and erupts all over them. They're going to keep on dropping stones. Chuan in a lot of danger. There's the roll forward. The counter plays from Weeha, finding two kills, including a core Bristleback. Only for a support Ancient Apparition and Misery farming along with Envy all during this time. Great stuff from Seeker. Yeah.
9 minute Midas, very good for the Lone Druid. And see Envy get a bottle refill, it looks like, but charge top, not going to commit to it as Earth Spirit's actually roamed up there. What's he thinking? Just looking to protect the Lone Druid a bit.
Gotta say, Weeha continues to impress on the Earth Spirit. 1-0-3 and he's been crucial in salvaging some of these hyper-aggressive newbie dives.
He just plays so in your face. He goes through this very tanky build, picks up the Treads Wand. He's sitting on like 12, 1300 HP. Then he goes into the Veil Blade Mail, and he's got all this, like, then he gets up to like 1500 HP with a Blade Mail, and you just never want to kill him or focus him down because of that.
Yeah, but with all the levels, he actually does a ton of damage, so you get punished for ignoring him. They are going to... get eyes here in the river on to Mr. Envy, who's a bit low on mana. Stunned, and Jackie Mao is down.
He was going all in to get that 10-minute rune.
Yeah, he had a remnant up the cliff, but that was not going to save him anyway. It was not nearly far enough away as they start hunting for Puppy. And they will control him, lock him down. My god, the physical damage from Newbie. Absolutely ridiculous. As they will easily kill him off and start looking for a tower in the bottom lane. There is a slow split push brewing top from the Earth Spirit, but it is not going to get the job done at the same pace.
It's a bit of the same as last game, just kind of uncharacteristic secret mistakes, like getting caught out, be it Envy or like we've seen Wii last game on the OD. Just these kind of pickoffs, which normally you wouldn't see out of those players.
They just want to rush.
Yeah. Newbie being so good at punishing and capitalizing on these mistakes, like they don't just get the pickoff, they then transition to a tower, a Roshan, an objective every single time, and they're just playing like such a cohesive.
They want to contest this. They just lost their Darkseer, and I think he had the mech complete, or nearly at that. Yeah, just about had it. Bought it in time, but they're rolling in a huge Magnetize from Weeha, combined with the Death Ward. It's going to bring Led down. He does get stunned through this. Almost dead off the bat, charging his way in. He accepts his fate. They will get the counter kill on the Witch Doctor, but it's small consolation. There's three drop in the end. Weeha, again, coming up huge in the big team fights. Not having the Darkseer there with the mech, well, that really hurt him.
Yeah, he's hung around bottom lane for a long time, and Envy's respawn TP in, just, I can't imagine it was anything beyond like a Fire Remnant forward into a Searing Chains to get the catch.
Well, suddenly things looking a whole lot better for Secret. 9-8 the score, and Lone Druid has been patiently farming away this whole time, Misery. Very close to leading the net worth chart. All three cores up there. It's still pretty close for Newbie, though. Looks like they want to fight again. They're going to engage around the Roshan pit once more. Treants are already there. Chuan does get caught out in the middle of the river. They're going to jump onto Weeha, but Envy arrives with two hero chains. Control trying to lock them down. The Ice Blast comes through, just clipping on Lei. Finally is the level 6 on Puppy. They're not done just yet. Envy looking to continue pursuit, but Hal turning with auto attacks. Envy's going to have to get out of here. The bashes could do him in. He's going to remnant back, but it's not very far. The goose stacks up. The quills finish the job. A 2-for-1 thus far, and they're hunting for more. Good body blocking for Misery. There's some nice micro. We'll keep him alive, but Leia just heads the other way to Pylai die as the cast continues to bounce, slows things down, but the damage is enormous. A newbie will grab a third kill, their turn to reply, and maybe their turn to take a roach.
Yeah, this is just that.
Oh, Magnetize is ready again, though.
Yeah, fighting into that did not go well for them last time, but this stage of the game where newbie have the ability to just constantly fight, Prophet can always kind of be active, ready to go, has gone through this very early game build with phase drums. Bristleback, an amazing fighter here like around the 12 to 15 minute mark, and a hero like Lone Druid comes to that fight but just doesn't offer anywhere near what a Bristleback or a Prophet does because he's farming up, he's holding on to 2k gold. Until he has a Radiance, he's just not really a big threat in a fight like that.
It's basically 2k net worth they don't actually have. We'll see a snipe on the top lane, though. Hal gets picked off, and that ends a killing spree. Good grab, the power of the Ancient Apparition Ember duo, fire and ice. Dealing with newbie. Oh, that's going to buy them a little breathing room. Looks like Envy is rushing the BOTs here, saving up a lot of gold. 2,000. About to be the amount. Do we have the Chaunt swap ready? Do they have eyes on Pylai Dire right now? They're going to drop a ward up the hill.
Oh, back in the road.
And they really want this thing.
There's Radiant Vision that saw them walk in, though.
And immediately, Secret Saint, nah.
Magnetized Ice Blast.
Not like that. Oh, God, newbie, this could leave a mark. They've got the veil up as well. They throw in the boulder. Ooh, that could have been super ugly. But still, they want to fight this. They're going to charge onto Weehaw. The wall gets dropped. They're committing a lot for the Earth Spirit. They will bring him down, and that is the team fight.
Yep, and they've got
out immediately.
So. Puppy just Ice Blast too early there. I think you need to wait for the Earth Spirit to be in position to get the rolling boulder, the stun. That should have been a huge secret win. When you catch three heroes in the pit, Ice Blast with Magnetize, you're just going to wipe them out. There is no defensive play newbie can make to keep them alive there, but they just rush it.
Did Envy buy the BOTs, or what is he going for?
He must have. He's had the money for it. It's on the courier, I guess.
Yeah, I was going to say, if he even had those there, he could have cleaned up, but... Oh, Envy in trouble. The Sprout's going to find him. He's got another Remnant. He does not have a teleport, but they'll let him go, knowing the Tier 1's up and Secret are respawning. Finally, the bots will arrive. Even a nice blast, just anticipating that little skirmish breaking out. Puppy was ready to assist, but won't be needed.
Refill up his mana and come back, it looks like, and try and find some pickoffs up here. But Prophet's Orchid coming soon, so it's going to get a lot harder for Envy to be playing aggressive and to even look to split push when the Orchid's online. And he doesn't... I'm not sure if what Envy's kind of philosophy on the Ember is, if he feels he needs to rush Manta, or typically I think you see at least the Battle Fury before the Manta, even when you're against an Orchid.
It used to be pretty popular to get the Manta first, especially in Southeast Asia, but yeah, I would say lately we have not seen much.
You're more worried about like the push threat and being able to defend high ground against a Prophet Bristle push with Venge, so Battle Fury kind of going to be more useful than a Manta there.
Look at this, the Bristle Blink just rushes it.
Damn.
Wants to just jump this Ember.
I think it's the first I've ever seen a Bristle like rush.
I've seen it, but it's never nearly this
early. It's like a late game when you've got like a Bissell, SMY, like SMY, BKB, then you get Blink. That's one thing. But.
Oh, they're committing onto Misery. Chuan's decided to go in. The rest of the team's like, no, what are you doing, Chuan? But now they got to go for it. The Vac's there. Misery's low, not finished off yet. The Magnetize comes out to combine with the Veil. A lot of damage onto newbie. Pylai Dai, though, is going to be the next man down, and a rampaging Armadillo charges forward, turning onto Weehaw now, who rolls the other direction. Come find Catch me if you can. He throws out the boulder, the stun, the Magnetize still going this whole time. Incredible Earth Spirit control to salvage this fight. Hal will drop as the Nature's Prophet. So far, a 2-for-3. Weehaw still alive, kicking them back. Has the Veil ready again. He's going to roll away. Still retreating.
Notes.
Incredible stuff from Weehaw, who just won't give up without a fight. But at long last, they'll muscle him down. A 3-for-3 in the end. And the Bristle wants to make it maybe a 3-for-4, but Envy says, yeah, I'm just going to be off here farming top. Don't worry about me.
If he had another 2 or 3 stones there, he could have done even more, but that was just insane what Earth Spirit can do.
That Magnetize just would not end. And the best part was he was not only getting extra stones for the Magnetize, but he was also using them for the kicks and the rolls.
I mean, Bristle stayed alive the entire fight.
He did 3,200. Yeah. Oh, my God.
I mean, Bristle did 2K, and it felt like Bristle was just spamming quills the entire time hitting heroes.
Jesus. That Veil build is really good.
Yeah.
Especially when you get it that early. Maybe newbie are going to think about a pipe after that, but they still have their Aegis, and they are going to pressure here.
I got to imagine Dax is probably like already on route to a pipe. I don't even think you want to finish your like your Greaves. You may even go pipe over Blink because of just how important that teamfight aspect is. Doesn't feel like they desperately need a Blink for the initiation. They're going to have the teamfight advantage, assuming they don't just all die to Magnetize.
Newbie grouping up in the mid lane and continue to apply pressure. About a minute and a half left, maybe a bit less on the Aegis, and they're trying to take advantage of it. Envy's the man in front here. He's going to hold the line, and they blink in with Mu, trying to immediately force him back. They will succeed. Envy, he had the Remnant, but it was in an awkward location over the tree line. Suddenly caught out here. It's in a bit of danger. The Ice Blast, though, comes through together with the Casca and the Maledict. Magnetize now flowing. Newbie are going to start melting to this. Oh, my goodness. Already two down. Bristleback out of the fight, but he will be coming back for round number two with the Aegis. Can he get anything done this time? He's going to dive onto Weeha. Not going to commit too much farther, so they lose Envy, who has felt like he's a bit on tilt this series as it's progressed. Some unnecessary deaths here. He did spend his gold at least. But these deaths are racking up. Still overall a win for Secret.
Another fight. 1,800 damage. He couldn't refresh the stones because he was low on HP. He had to roll out back to his own base, but that was just another huge showing coming out from the Earth Spirit.
And that's with Envy just basically doing nothing and getting caught out right away. You know, if he gets to a point where he has farm and can contribute, that's going to be a real problem for Newbie.
And Lone Druid, very close to Radiance, had like 4.7k gold. I guess he hadn't bought the relic yet and just needs the relic and Radiance recipe. So Misery, I think he just bought the Radiance recipe at base and probably just needs a bit more for the relic. What's he looking at? Yeah. Yeah. So he's got a 19-20 minute Radiance.
This is the dream timing, I would say, for Lone Druid.
It still doesn't feel like Secret are able to be like, okay, we've got Radiance, we're stronger in a fight now, because Envy is going to get, well, now there's an Orchid to counter him, and if Newbie can get to like mech plus pipe, they're going to be stronger.
Speaking of Envy, does get caught out and picked off. The Orchid works its magic.
Fresh pickup, and Envy was not ready. That was on respawn. You mentioned it was on tilt, and I was going to completely agree with you. Well, he's showing it. Playing. Like,
honestly, though,
NB.
Like they're very strong without him. With the Radiance, the Veil, and the Earth Spirit, like I feel like that plus an Ice Blast can wipe Newbie, aside from the Bristle, maybe.
And something a lot of the players have talked about, when you're like the one drafting or captaining, your play sometimes suffers a bit. It happened to S4 on the past Secret team, where he wasn't playing like that world-class mid that he was known to be when he was doing the drafting and captaining. I don't know if Envy's making all the shot calling, but he has been the drafter for this tournament, so...
Yeah, and it seems like Secret have been unsure of how they want to approach their draft.
You have to multitask and think about so much more than just your own individual play that sometimes it does suffer a little bit as a result.
They're going to beat down that bear a bit, but Newbie not able to kill it off. Well, we'll see if Envy can get it together. He does have a lot of help here from the team. His house going to TP away. Back to the well. Howard has taken quite a beating there in the bottom lane.
Arcane Rune Bristle, that's...
Ooh. It's and a haste. Oh, they're looking for the Lone Druid. TP's coming out. Misery's got to be careful. Does Newbie have any vision? Doesn't
good
look
map
like
awareness.
It.
And good bear position to scout them when the smoke pops.
And you can see Pi just hiding in the trees. But, oh, Pi, he's going to end up tanking this one. This will be another kill to Team Newbie. Yep. Hal joins it. Immediately they're ready to go onto the tower. Ice Blast comes through along with the Radiance Burn. Might be able to kill off the support here. Sprouting the bear. Newbie will back away. And wise they do, as the Earth Spirit is hot on the chase.
If there was like a stat for smoke ganks tanked, I feel like Pilot Eye would be number one, without a doubt.
He's definitely in the top few. And especially with the way that they play, it's really big for the support to be tanking those ganks.
Absolutely. Because, same with the old Cloud9, where it's a similar kind of thing where they're often split farming and playing a lot more kind of, like, quote-unquote, Rat Dota type playstyle. So having a support who can kind of fill that role and tank the smoke gank and get you that scouting information is very beneficial. Ideally, no one does, but if it's someone, it's better it's Pilot Eye.
Newbie in quite good shape here overall, though. They still have some time before Envy becomes a relevant factor in the game. And I imagine they're going to wait for the next Roche before they start threatening the high ground, perhaps, as they all tank up here. Ogre Cloak coming out now for Lay. And the Bristleback just continuing to beef up in his own right. Definitely don't want to let it drag too much, though, with the amount of split push Secret have. just the bear ratting its way around. Yeah. It's going to be very tough to deal with.
It's going to get harder and harder to deal with the split push, but when I see these like support duos like Venge, Spiritbreaker, they just go so well late game. Like Venge scales amazingly well, just because of the aura, the Roche taking potential, the swap saves. You've got a low cooldown stun. Like this hero late game is just incredible with what it can do, even in that kind of 4 or 5 position role. Spiritbreaker, similar thing, having Nether Strike to go through BKBs can benefit a lot from just having a small item here or there.
It's absolutely for sure.
Late game will come down a lot more to the execution, and Secret don't have that big like team fight spell necessarily. Like the Magnetize for now is good, but you get to late game, it's the Darkseer Vacuum Wall, and even like a Spirit Breaker with the AoE charge and the Nether Strike, which does a lot more than just Magnetize. Is pure damage. It doesn't actually give you a crazy team fight. The Boulder Smash is the more important spell in the late game for Secret, as far as the Earth Spirit's concerned. And outside of that, they're kind of lacking a team fight specialist. They will have to entirely be reliant on the split push. No. And not just like the big team fight. Newbie also have the better catch with the Venge.
Oh, they're charging. They're trying to find that Earth Spirit. Leh is going to look for the Nether Strike. He commits on the Weehaw very far in. Has the backup, though. The back comes through. A magnificent one, but the Magnetize also fantastic. And they got off the Maledict through this together with the Death Ward. It's going to drive Newbie back, send them on their heels. 3 melt, and that was just a bridge too far for Newbie to dive. They catch out Moo as well. Again, Weehaw connecting, and Envy is going to arrive, clean up, collect a little bit of additional gold for his trouble. Ends the streak on the Bristle. That is the Battle Fury, and... well, Newbie just bit off way more than they could chew there.
Yeah. I mean, I honestly still, even seeing that, like, I stand by Newbie have the better team fight, just not when you give Witch Doctor, like, a cask onto 2 or 3 heroes with a 2 to 3 hero Maledict.
And they got the great Magnetize with the Veil.
Veil Maledict? Like, oh, that's just brutal damage coming out. Like,
that was just a really overzealous dive. Yeah. They went super far. And Secret knew it was coming for at least like 5 seconds before the Nether Strike even hit.
Yeah, Newbie don't need to go for that. They must have just thought they had that pickoff on Earth Spirit. And if they kill Earth Spirit, they win the fight. But Pilai Dai, just the exact position he needed to be in to turn that one around.
So is this just going to be the straight Ags? No, he gets a BKB.
Oh, Nurse.
Like, good against the Orchid.
Oh, yeah.
Probably the biggest way that they could shut down the Secret team fight would be silencing
him. He gets incredibly tanky off this. He's actually farming ridiculously well, like on par with an Eternal Envy Ember Spirit.
Who has not come to like a single fight. And the ones he has come to, he's largely died. Meanwhile, we'll complete a more modest item here. Just getting a Sanjin Yasha to call his own.
I think Secret likely to find the game get slowed down a bit by Newbie now. They're going to play more towards that late game. Farm up their BKBs on heroes like Spirit Breaker, Bristleback, and secure Roshan. Farm their Ancients, farm their side of the map, their jungle, and it's going to be up to Secret to make plays over the next kind of stage of the game, or contest Roshan because of that.
Well, speaking of the Roche, Newbie have been really prioritizing this guy, and they are going back to it now shortly after the respawn. Bringing the Treants in, the Space Cow, also sprinting his way towards the pit. Nobody from Secret in position to contest. They've got great fighting potential around this pit, but they don't have the map control to get in there. So it is another Aegis to Moo. And now the question becomes, what do Newbie look for with this Aegis? There's only 2 outer towers left. Not too many freebies.
I don't feel it's a huge sin to just farm a bit with it or try and find a pickoff, but I don't think they should be looking to just 5-man push and break high ground. At most, they take some out of tower. It's like tier 2s. But yeah, there we go. Darkseer putting together the hood. Going to be building into the pipe. But pipe, BKBs, like these are the kind of items I feel like they need to be getting to stand a better chance to withhold themselves against the Magnetize, the Ice Blast.
Look at this. How is going Maelstrom? So we're not going to see the what seems to be the standard build, the Octarine Ags.
Yeah. Mjolnir on Bristleback is pretty damn scary. He's popping on him and he goes blinking, running in.
Running in onto Pilai Dai, but the stun interrupts the charge. A sick kick from Wii, and then he rolls in, pops his BKB. Ice Blast is there, gets off the Magnetize, so too. They manage to pop the Witch Doctor Maledict, and he just goes to work with auto attacks. He cancels 2 heroes on the retreat. He drags back the boulder, almost finishing off Hal solo. He's also killed off the Spirit Breaker through this, but then the mech comes in, and Newbie are going to converge on Wii. Perhaps he's in too far. Now he needs backup, needs help, needs that bear roar, needs it now. Misery there with the save, the bailout. They've lost their profit. They they jump back in with the Bristle, eager for a little vengeance, but Wii kicks them away. They just can't finish off this Earth Spirit. Finally, they get the job done. My goodness gracious, he is out of his mind right now.
Lundred illusion. Looked like a mud golem or something. What is this? But man, yeah, Wii just goes running in.
Even if they lose this game, Wii has been playing absolutely godly on Earth Spirit. Jurex is competition.
Absolutely.
At this point,
and
then some.
This tournament has just made me think just that is Jurex the best Earth Spirit player? Because there's
a new sheriff in town here.
There's looking like there's two or three amazing Earth Spirit players now. It's no longer just going to be the Jurex show and that hero.
They have completed their pipe. And considering where Secret's damage comes from, that's a big pickup for newbie.
Yeah. And the mech kind of kept Prophet alive for much longer in that fight. Hal played, I think Hal just thought he was dead because he had the Orca, could have used it earlier on the Earth Spirit.
Prophet was looking for the Ember in the trees, but Envy is able to jump himself away in time. Used his last remnant for that. Has gone for the blink. So full-on rat build coming out now.
Yep. It's like a kind of poor man's solution to the Orchid, because you've got to be able to do damage before you can. If you get silence, you can instant blink away if you're fast. And
he is just not able to get this Maelstrom into his inventory. It's been a while since Hal originally bought the components. Finally, we'll get it.
Loon Druid AC. The other nice thing about the Maelstrom Mjolnir build is it means you're not entirely physical damage, because Loon Druid now has AC as well. With Warcry, he gets a ton of armor, and having a bit of magic damage as well means you're not just relying on a Bristleback physical damage to get kills.
Yeah, that plus the Venge is a pretty heavy commitment. So, newbie, after that last sequence of events, let's see if they can get anything more. Still have one, I think there's still a tier 2 top, right, for the Radiant? Got the one outer tower. Yeah, but that's it. So, beyond that, if they look for objectives, they're going to have to go high ground. And going high ground against Secret is no laughing matter.
I think that's where they're going to struggle for a bit. But they can fight on their own terms outside of on the map. And like the bear is actually kind of hard to use against even just something like Nasal Goo from the Bristleback. Gets kited quite badly and becomes a lot squishier and easier to kill with all the slows.
Well, the items just keep on coming for Weeha, and he has earned them. That is for sure. Gets the blade mail now. So he's now got 20 armor, 2,000 health, magic immunity, and he does an insane amount of damage. Might even look for the jump.
What doesn't
the hero do? He apparently can't BKB dodge that one. Now he's going to pop the BKB, even deploys the magnetize, and it's going to send Mu packing, but Mu's okay with that.
It's a pretty short cooldown ultimate. And 80 seconds. Just another thing the hero has going for it. Use a magnetize to no avail. Okay. 75 seconds later, it's back.
Envy getting chased out by the Prophet a bit. They did have a charge streaking in, but the timing is not going to be right to even threaten for a kill.
Yeah, Orca was used, but didn't look like they came close to catching him. Oh, he's heaping top. Possibly Secret. Eh, they don't have magnetized. It's a very hard time for them to take a fight.
Chuan, maybe? He sees Envy and he wants a piece of that action.
Take the free back kill.
Not easy. Oh, you say free. I don't know. Might be a free Mu kill. Chuan's forced to swap him out. He does manage to dodge the Ice Blast as well. Very good disengage from newbie. And now the re-engage with the Vacuum Wall connecting on everybody, forcing them all back. The Death Ward is there to zone out the newbie heroes as they chase into the cast bounces again. The Maledict onto two heroes. Secret holding serve, and then Weeha rolling away, laughing quietly to himself. So a lot of really good individual plays from both teams there, but Secret, in the end, able to come out on top.
Yeah. They didn't have the BKB magnetized, but didn't matter for them. And maybe, yeah. They it was really nice time to engage. It was as the Aegis expired, so they knew they didn't have to worry about the hero just kind of running in, dying with Aegis, coming back and completely screwing them over.
Newbie now grabbing their Vladimir's Offering as well, so trying to put these items together to deal with the Ember Spirit's growing physical damage and get into that base. They still have not taken that last tier too.
Yeah, it's just like the full everyone itemizing for the five man, getting the Vlads, getting BKBs on all your core heroes. Bristleback, that was his latest pickup now. Like having a lot of just kind of no real big scary late game items. There's no like Abyssal AC type items, but like BKB, SMY, Vanguard, Blink, just very stable. and strong kind of mid-game oriented focus for a newbie.
Well, Vlad's to match the newbie Vlad's secret grabbing theirs, and Misery continues to keep the farm going. He is still the leader in net worth after all of this, while Envy crawls his way back into the game and finds himself third most farm. They are going to isolate Lei. They get the boulder pullback stun silence combo, and down he will go.
And they've, like, newbie have decided a big problem for their lineup right now is that Spirit Breaker doesn't have BKB. That's why he keeps going to this top lane trying to farm, get some alone time, because they want to finish his BKB so he can be the initiator to start the fight. You can't expect to have Darkseid just be able to run and get a good vacuum wall unless someone starts the fight for him. So having Spirit Breaker in that position works for them. That's what. That's how they got a good vacuum wall last fight, but Spirit Breaker always dies without a BKB.
Envy, Daedalus coming very soon here.
Yeah, he's not even
keeps
bothering
the pressure
with
up top.
The Manta against the Orchid. That's just how confident he is.
Oh. Moo, thwarted by the bear. That thing's really annoying.
So obnoxious. You want to fight? No. It's like a poor man's Song of the Siren.
And right? Then when he does want to fight, he gets like five roots and bashes in a row, you know?
Oh, yeah.
What a hero.
And just mass armor now. So yeah, Vlad's with the AC means, again, newbie don't really have much outside of physical damage right now.
Definitely have lost some of their map control here. The lanes are pushing out a lot more for Secret. You can see them just feeling more confident, spreading out. Spreading their wings across the map.
Prophet just isn't as scary as he needs to be at this stage to threaten those heroes who are split pushing. Like, feels like he's not in a position where he can't be pushing out lanes too easily because he will get caught out. There's Ember, there's Earth Spirit, there's the AA Ice Blast, which is global. Doesn't go for the Axe Epis, so he's not going to push out the lanes as much by nature. And until he gets something like a Scythe of Ice, he's not going to be able to really scare the Ember Spirit with just the Orchid alone anymore.
Yeah, that and or a Spirit Breaker getting a Shadow Blade, but given that he's going BKB, we're not going to see that.
Yeah, if Spirit Breaker had a better time this game, I think there's like 8 deaths, 9 deaths on Spirit Breaker. If he had BKB maybe 5-10 minutes ago and was already like on the way to a Shadow Blade, I think newbie would be in a really good position. But the Spirit Breaker not being there, and this is an important hero for them scaling into the late game, makes it a bit trickier. But on the Secret side, similarly, or even in worse position, is their supports. Like, their AA is not gone for Midas, just has a Ghost Scepter, will not be able to farm an Axe Scepter this game unless somehow he miraculously survives a team fight, gets a kill on like a carry, and suddenly gets like K gold out of it. So Secret aren't going to see their support scale into the late game. Earth Spirit's not quite peaking as far as what he can get item-wise. He can still throw in the Axe Scepter and then you get that crazy Axe upgrade, but some of their heroes are getting at least close to that max capacity.
Envy continues his ascent, third in net worth now, and closing in on second as he completes a Daedalus. The items keep on piling in, and well, meanwhile, newbie yet to break base. Let's see if they're going to be able to do it with this third Aegis now. Cheese will also be picked up, and it's a very quick rush. They grab it, but Secret are looking to contest. There's the BOT in from Envy, quickly backs away, and the boulder kick comes through. Weeha engaging, committing his whole combo onto Chuan, who's very tanky. Not an easy grab. Envy jumps in to avenge stun, but there's not much follow-up here. He isolates Chuan, will bring him down. However, the trade is going to be Misery. The big bear has been slain and sent packing as they teleport forward, looking for Pylai Dai. He goes for the TP out. Charge coming through. Oh, almost got him in time. Envy escaping right as they also chase after him. He's going to Remnant out. Blinks away. Has BOTs up in 10. Looks like he will dodge the gank. So they were forced to pop the Prophet Cheese there in the midst of that.
Okay, Prophet Cheese and a lot of BKBs. Not just the Prophet one on the teamfight recap. That was like Bristle. I think everyone used like 3 Spirit Breaker used his. Bristle did not, it looks like. But yeah, I saw a Spirit Breaker. And then
the Earth Spirit uses this as well.
Oh yeah, Earth Spirit, that's right. Yeah. Let's say, I'm pretty sure I saw a lot of gold shiny heroes.
Uh-oh, Envy! Envy-chan! He'll TP away. But yeah, when that Hex comes out, things will get a little trickier for Secret. Assuming he gets one. Still a ways away.
I'm a little nervous for newbie though. There was a kind of phase where there was a lot of teams running Bristle mid. Liquid were doing it with Fata, a lot of the CIS teams were doing it, and it would just dominate for the early to mid game, and then you'd get to late game and about 45-ish minutes in, suddenly the hero just got kited, didn't do enough damage because it goes for all these items like BKB, SMY, Vanguard, which aren't like these crazy late game single target DPS items, and then suddenly it starts to fall off, which is maybe where we're approaching with Moose Bristleback if Nubian aren't careful.
Yeah, you're also getting to the point where they have the burst with Envy and on the data list, as long as he doesn't get caught.
Got Melodic to help you out. You've got,
and they don't have a combo like Swap Lasso this game. You've got Swap into Nether Strike, Swap into Orchid, I guess. It's
swap Hex.
Not
get that Hex up. That's going to be the.
That's not going to be for a while if you're a newbie.
Yeah, they have the they spent the money on the Mjolnir, which I think is definitely worth it when you can pop it on Bristleback. Yeah, and that makes him a
the way they've itemized is not to take this ultra late game. Gone for, I mean, you mentioned all the Bristle items, and you've got Maelstrom, Orchid. These are much more mid-game focused items. Mass BKBs. They do want to end this game fairly soon, newbie, if they can.
Yeah, we'll see what Bristle gets. If he gets something like an AC, it's basically saying that they want to end and not let it go too late. If he goes for more like Abyssal, he's saying I can go late game. I can also pick off someone like the Ember Spirit, Blink Abyssal, a great way to initiate and try and kill Envy.
Abyssal would be really good.
Yeah, I quite like it as a Vanguard replacement. Then you can TP in the Prophet. The problem is with Prophet TPing in is he can't do damage. He has to instantly Orchid, but then Envy just blinks away.
Found Weeha down in the river, has the BKB, tries to roll away, and in a moment of panic, he's going to hesitate here. Now gets caught out. Now we'll roll with the BKB, and Ember zipping out as well. Newbie trying to get vision here for the chase forward. Mu with the blink in, Wee with the jump away. It looks like he should escape in the end, though. Too late. Continues the pursuit, just barely out of range to lock him down. Nice call there from Weeha.
Yep. If Too late may get a BKB himself. It felt like you could see in that last team fight where he gets stunned, silence. He could definitely benefit from a BKB, but at the same time, the hexes are just going to become a crucial item for newbie as well. So probably a bit of a decision to make there whether he goes for a BKB or hex on Darkseer.
Well, Envy had a very rough start this game, but he is back in it now on a mega kill streak, 9-5-4, leader in net worth. And more secret, their core's getting confident, getting aggressive, and keeping these lanes pushed out against newbie, making it harder to actually use this Aegis.
This is starting to turn into like one of those classic Envy Ember games. You're going to see rapiers and
get some caffeine, guys, or have a nap because we might be in for a long one.
And the draft doesn't push. Like you've got Lone Druid, yes, but Ember not a pushing hero at all. Earth Spirit,
none of them are
team fights, but
Druid.
Not going to push. And newbie have good high ground defense with the Darkseer and just Bristle as well, being such a great hero just to engage with, have run in. There's the threat of the swap catch that can pull heroes deep into the newbie base, so. No way for Secret to push this one unless they're winning a fight and team wiping newbie out.
You can just see in Envy's playstyle that he is more and more feeling like he's got the position he needs to play aggressively.
That's where Spirit Breaker wished he bought a Midas this game. Same for AA, the Ghost Scepter's been like nice to save him in some of the fights where Bristle's like blinking in trying to kill him, but.
Yeah, Puppy is up to 2k. Curious to see what he goes for.
But I think more so for the Spirit Breaker, not getting a Midas this game is proving to be a bit costly. Hard to really tell at the time, because you're expecting to maybe be able to fight and win earlier. And there we go. Will be Abyssal from Bristleback. He picks up a Basher and almost has the money. Doesn't actually have to replace the Vanguard since he opens up a slot from the Aegis.
It's going to be a big item for Mu now. And maybe some pickoff potential. This is their first true, like, instant initiation.
So, in Envy's response, maybe to get something like a Lincoln's if he sees this. And he's got a lot of money banked up. He's got two empty item slots. Well, item slots he can make kind of open up. So it could be like a Lincoln's Rapier type.
Look here. This could be the debut. The Abyssal's online and... He thinks about a leap in onto Weeha, but not going to
escape. Blink, and then you roll boulder, and suddenly you're 3,000 range away.
Yeah, maybe Prophet is the counter with the global TP. But you got to know where he's going.
Yeah, so Prophet 3k. Mentioned Hex. This feels essential. Always has to be the next item. I think with the way they're struggling to find kills and end this game, Darkseer is probably thinking that a Hex is going to give them more playmaking potential than a BKB. And yeah, he's going Hex. So
double Hex.
Definitely agree at this stage, based on their inability to find kills, that Hex is going to offer more.
Yeah, too late, getting close to his own. Yeah. So
and Prophet hasn't bought anything yet, but if it's anything other than a Hex, I'd be pretty shocked.
Newbie are going to try to call on the Exterminators and clean up this infestation that the Ember has created.
So
they'll have three ways to deal with the rat. Yeah. So
and that's
pretty good at it at that point. Plus the Spiritbreaker maybe gets a Shadow Blade.
Yep. Yeah, I think that'd be a great item pickup.
And then Envy will go from feeling like he can do whatever he wants to being very nervous and needing supports behind him.
Lincoln's becomes very core for him, but even then there's ways to cancel it. Like you can insta-break it with a charge and then have the hero like ready to Hex or like Blink Abyssal as you
over near the Dire Ancients, some warding going on. They are posting up a bit here. It seems like Secret are getting in position to try and fight this one. A TP in the Ember to the north, the Earth Spirit rolls down from the south.
China's jam, they don't really want to lose this one.
Oh, they really are hunting from Weeha with the long range kick, Chuan with the clever footwork to dodge it, but still he's been caught out here, gets silenced up. The bear comes in with the Veil burn damage. Chuan is going to be going down. That's the gem picked off. Do they get anything else? They're still hunting here. No, newbie are going to back.
Yeah. And the gem not the biggest deal. Like, Venge's item progression is kind of already stagnating, so you can just buy another one when it's available. And there's the Shadow Blade, so. Like newbie doing everything right as far as itemization goes. It's just Secret are outmaneuvering them around the map, preventing any pickoffs. You've got your Abyssal Blade. You're going to have Hexes soon. You're going to have the Shadow Blade on Spirit Breaker. Can you actually find these pickoffs? That's kind of the big question mark right now as far as this game's concerned.
And Hao is getting close to the Hex at this point. 5,000 gold banked up. And a fresh Roshan, number 4, at 44 minutes in. Ready to go. Though Aegis has not proven to do much this game aside from give some gold.
I'll give them overconfidence to push and feed Secret kills.
it's maybe done more for Secret than newbie.
But yeah, 1200 to Daxir Hex. Similar story for the Prophet, I think it was. And with Rosh back up, they don't have buybacks here, so Secret could try and capitalize on that if they realize what's going on. But lanes. And Prophet, Wrath of Nature, is just going to keep on pushing these lanes out, making things and life a bit more difficult, but Envy always good at deep pushing.
Yeah, that and the bear.
What did Envy buy? He's got the courier going to the shop. Is it going to be Rapier or Lincoln's is the question. Lincoln's, okay. Safe choice, and the Rapier follow-up is most likely, almost certain, unless he needs MKB, but no one's got evasion, so Rapier will be his final item, and then he may even get. And then he starts getting backup rapiers.
Gets his moon shards to hit buildings quicker.
You can, I think, even like replacing like something like a battlefield with a rapier and at certain stages is nice as well. So he's in that luxury territory.
Depends how hard they're pushing with the Prophet, but yeah, his build doesn't really let him clear the waves that easily. Nocturne, no eggs.
It's more, if you're high ground defending, you sometimes, I've seen Embers replace it just for the single target hero damage. But yeah, both teams know Rosh is up. This makes life interesting for the two teams. Newbie have decisions to make. They're the ones who kind of have to decide, do we go in or not? And Secret are going to kind of play reactionary to Newbie's decision here.
Well, game is definitely slowed down to Secret's liking. 46 minutes in, score 27-21. Pretty damn even overall in terms of map control and levels of confidence for both teams. Newbie are starting to inch their way forward into that Rosh pit, but Puppy keeps tabs on it with the Ice Vortex.
Top lane's being pressured. Envy. Oh, okay, Envy's on it, though.
Yeah, this game, they have a hero that can actually get those lanes pushed out. No Weaver this time.
So Swap Hex is kind of the combo to look out for now. Did they get the Darkseer Hex? No, they didn't. Prophet. No. Okay, he's getting close to it. Yeah,
he's going MKB, it looks like. All right, they have found Puppy, though, to start this one off. Oh, off the bat, the Ice Blast is chucked out, but Puppy's down into the trees. He will fall. Weeha could be in trouble here. Moo trying to control him and lock him down, but there's the big combo coming out from the Earth Spirit together with the Death Ward. Pummels down the Spirit Breaker, at least for the time being. Hao, meanwhile, dropping on the Nature's Prophet as Misery starts to chop some wood. Brings down two in his own right. We'll force them out. Too late. Now the third grab of the fight. Envy not going to be able to burst them down in time, though. Still, they force them back. They're going to lose Chuan as well. The bear reigns supreme. And now Secret. Oh, reinvigorated are walking into that Roche pit.
Everyone's getting super kited. Like, the AA stays alive for so bloody long just because of a ghost scepter. They have no magic damage to kill these heroes. Same thing for Misery. They kind of half went on Misery, got him down to half HP. He pops ghost scepter, and then they can't focus him. And then suddenly Misery just managed to get himself in a better position and stay alive. Like, these... They're actually getting owned in that team fight solely because of ghost scepters, it felt like, more than anything.
Secret now, for the first time this game, get an Aegis, get a cheese, and should be officially in the lead here. Overall, maybe they do need the Hex here as well in the Darkseer.
They desperately need some Hexes. And
and the MKB. It was an awkward time to not have those items. They were so close to both. Got punished. Spirit Breaker, or rather, Lone Druid with his own Abyssal Blade up on the bear. So continues his impressive farm progression. Envy hunts the Darkseer to the south. He almost
juked them by running towards them.
And then he jukes them by dying.
Yeah, try and kill me now, guys.
Yeah.
Can't do that.
Joke's on you. I'm already dead.
I really don't like Prophet going for MKB. This seems super suspect. Not getting Hex. I guess the logic is that Darkseer is already going for one, so you've got the swap Hex there, but their lack of control and disable, like, they can't... You Hex, you can't go Scepter. You can control the Ember. The house problem has not been dishing out right-click damage. It's either staying alive or...
The house got issues here. Hello. Yeah. Gets caught out in the trees. Witch Doctor, our observer, is falling asleep there at the wheel. Lost control of the keyboard, but that's okay. They still get the kill in the end.
Envy playing responsible Dota, not picking up rapiers. He probably looked at that last fight where the Darkseer just TP'd away.
Oh, our spirit rolling in now, looking for the bristleback.
Oh, he kicked him.
And he kicked him back. Oh, moves out pretty far.
Envy, that's Bristle over there. They don't want to fight him, I guess, with the BKB. But looking at the end of the last fight, he could have potentially mini-bashed the Darkseer to cancel a TP. But other than that, evasion is not really a thing for newbie. They've got a Solar Crest, is what they've got there. Mm.
Now Secret are getting confident, marching up the bottom lane with the Lone Druid. They're going to smack down the tower here, and now they do Siege incredibly fast with a Lone Druid this big. So newbie are going to have to make their stand on the base. They have a buyback on the Prophet. The lanes are pushing in. Ember's going to join the party. Look for that Weeha initiation with the Remnant. He is going to drag the Bristle back into the middle of the team. Can they bring him down, though? The BKB's there. Abyssal Blade controlling move for now. And he's just not really all that tanky at this stage. They jump forward with Wee. They go for the kick, but he's got the BKB able to survive. Magnetize does get committed. Newbie are forced back, though. See the power of the Earth Spirit to catch heroes out.
And that's going to be the secret way to win in the late game, is to get a pick off, a key catch, using the Earth Spirit Ags, pull someone in, and that core hero ideally doesn't have buyback. So, outside of that, pushing high ground, very difficult. Like, they manage to get the T3 tower while Prophet's dead, but they back off once Prophet comes back alive, recognizing that that is a bit of a threat to them. More likely, newbie will try and engage using that Darkseer at that point.
Hex is now online at long last, but it feels like it may be a bit too late here.
Yeah, they're going to start looking for that swap Hex. But Secret aren't going to play into that. They're well aware it's been coming for a long time.
And they also have buybacks now. Envy's got the Lincolns as well.
Newbie's teamwork's been very good, though, so I don't put it past them to do something like a charge to break the Lincolns and then insta-swap Hex or get a Blink Abyssal.
But it's going to take that is the main concern.
Oh, yeah. At this stage, for newbie to win, it takes some incredible execution. For Secret, they have much more room for error. It's a lot easier to just play their draft out. Like, as far as which position you'd rather be in right now, it's Secret by far. I don't think Secret have a massive lead, but it's much easier for them just to close out this game. For newbie, they have to make some next level plays.
Well, the siege is going to commence now. They get the bear up in front, but it will be sprouted, controlled, and take some big damage. Meanwhile, they've dragged Mu in, but this time Mu is on the aggression. Throws out the Abyssal Blade onto Pileidai, almost killing off the bear. They do manage to kill it once. Got the resummon available, though. And Team Secret are going to recommence the siege, it looks like. Got to be careful not to lose the bear again. They know the BKB is on cooldown for the Bristle, so the next time they pull him in, Mu may end up going down and be forced to buy back. Envy gets up in their face, jumping in. And bouncing out. Ice Blast coming through. There's the swap initiation, trying to catch one out. And they do manage to isolate Weehawk. Can they lock him down? Envy starts to cleave his way through them, though. Massive damage from the Ember Spirit. And then goes to work with auto attacks. Really tearing them apart. And then the Death Ward comes out. Almost finish off the entirety of the team. Those last few bounces from the Death Ward get the job done. That's four dead. It's about to be a team wipe. It is. They double buyback to hold the line. But it might be too little too late here. Hao slowly working on Puppy. Mu rejoining the fray. But the Ember Spirit damage stacks up. Hao, this could well be a dieback. It will be. Profit down twice. And Kowell could be next as the Bristleback as they chase forward, trying to finish him off. Envy diving deep. We've seen this before, Secret. It takes them forever to come online, but eventually Envy gets to that point where he is a threat and he is a stone cold killer. And with that, Jackie Secret hang on. Ooh. And force game three. But man, they had to work for it.
Classic Team Secret Dota right now. It's scrappy, it's effective though. It gets them the win. And Newbie, like they play the kind of Dota which normally does very well against it, but this game Secret just kind of elevated their play. Newbie never really had the ability to catch the Ember Spirit after like he got the Blink Dagger up, and the Orca just didn't really get enough value out of it. And I think the Nature's Prophet experiment may be something we won't see Newbie go back towards as much. That was a hero that just didn't really seem to give them enough out of the safe lane, but more than anything, it's just a really well played game by Secret. And the other big problem I think for Newbie more than anything was the Ghost Scepters. Every single fight I'm watching, like, Puppy, he's in a Sprout, surrounded by three enemy heroes, and he's just Ghost Sceptered, lives, then force stuffs out, and somehow keeps himself alive. These Ghost Scepters were actually the biggest problem Newbie faced this game, more than, like, any amount of farm on the Lone Druid, the Ember, the Earth Spirit Magnetized. Once you got to late game, it was the fact they had no magic damage and no defusals to counter the Ghost Scepter.
They just couldn't close them out, and eventually Secret do come online with their unstoppable late-game juggernaut. So with that, guys, we are headed to our first Game 3 in a little while. We'll see who gets eliminated here. Newbie versus Secret. Loser goes home. Winner stays alive in the lower bracket of MDL. Stick around. We'll be back.